The Mr. Excel podcast is sponsored by Mr. Excel XL, a book with 40 plus Excel tips, Excel cartoons, cocktails, tweets, and jokes. Learning Excel from Mr. Excel podcast, episode 1975, Filter by Selection. Hey, welcome back to the Mr. Excel netcast. I'm Bill Jell, and I know a lot of you use the data filter command, but frankly, this is a slow command to use. If I needed a filter to one particular customer here, well, you have the first click to click on data, second click for filter, that gives us the drop downs. Then we open the drop down, that's click number 3, uncheck select all, click number 4, and then I don't know how many clicks this counts to drag down through this long list to find what we want. Let's call that click number 5, click number 6 for the customer, click number 7 for okay, there's a much, much faster way to go. Now, before Excel 2007 gave us a million rows, I used to be a pretty big fan of Microsoft Access, not because I was doing any database things, but because I could pull a large CSV file in, maybe 80,000 rows, break it into two pieces with queries, and then take it back to Excel on two different worksheets. But now, you know, hey, look, we have not just 65,536 rows, but 1,048,576. I don't have more data than that, so I frankly haven't used Access since Excel 2007 came along. But one of my favorite features back in Access in the filter group was something called Filter by Selection. And all you would have to do is just choose the cell that had what you wanted and click Filter by Selection. And I remember back when I started the podcast, boy, back in 2007, someone wrote and said, you know, Filter by Selection is so good in Access, why don't we have that in Excel, all right? And that time I actually wrote a macro, and somewhere out on YouTube is the video where I show that filter by selection macro. And, you know, like the next day someone wrote and said, wait a second, why did you write that macro? And in fact, it was before 2007, because we were still in Excel 2003. They said, you know, filter by selections in Excel 2003. It was hidden. You couldn't find it. Now, here's how you would find it today. First off, we're either going to add it to the ribbon, or we're going to add it to the Quick Access Toolbar, and I always add it to the Quick Access Toolbar up here. So I'm going to right-click and say that I want to customize the Quick Access Toolbar. And they start out by showing me a list of, you know, 40 or so popular commands, but this isn't a popular command because no one knows that it's there. So we're either going to go to All Commands or my favorite Friday afternoon activity, Commands Not in the Ribbon, right? These are things that Microsoft is hiding from us, things that are in Excel that they don't want us to see, maybe because they want to remove them someday, right? So this is great to go through here and see if anything looks interesting that you might be able to use. Now, of course, you would think that filter by selection would either be in the Fs or down in the Ss, like selection, filter by, but it's not in either of those. What we have to do is we have to go back to the old name. Remember the old name back in Excel 2003? It was called an auto filter, right? So there is another icon called filter if we went to all commands, but we want the one called auto filter. We're going to add that, right? See, and that's the problem. It's mislabeled. They call it auto filter classic. That's really filter by selection. So here's how it works. If I want one particular customer, I click that customer. That's one click. Don't even have to go to the data tab. Just come up here to the quick access toolbar and bam, there we are. It is a two-click way to filter. If I need to filter even further, all the gizmos, choose gizmo, click filter by selection, choose Monday, filter by selection, all right, and a really, really fast way to go. Now, hey, just one caution. Of course, what I would love is if I could do choose the customer, choose the day, and choose the product, and then do filter by selection, but unfortunately, that does not work. You can't do it that way. Too bad. Too bad. That would have been a cool trick. All right. So just to recap here, filter by selection, that great tool from Access, works in Excel. I talked about how to add an icon to the Quick Access Toolbar, and then commands not in the ribbon, contains Excel features that you won't find. And again, a plug for the book, Mr. Excel XL. This is just tip number 2 out of more than 40 tips in the book. Click that I in the upper right-hand corner to buy the book. And thanks to Sam Rad on the Excel team, not for suggesting filter by selection for the book, but actually he's the guy that formalized filter by selection, made it be a real feature. So if you love this feature, tip of the hat to Sam Rad for that. Thanks for stopping by. We'll see you next time for another netcast from Mr. Excel.